other big items that were named during the State of the Union, one of those being a focus on the cost of prescription medication, a big jolt to big pharma in this country. The president saying it is unacceptable that Americans pay vastly more than people in other countries for the exact same drugs made in the same place. It's wrong, unfair, and together we can stop it. He also said we should require drug companies, insurance companies, and hospitals to disclose real prices to foster competition and bring costs down. And trust me, this has some people in the pharmacy industry spooked. Seth Denson here is the president and co-founder of GDP Advisors. Seth, welcome back.
Steve, good to be back with you.
Good to have you here. So, I mean, this, and by the way, I agree with the idea of truth in pricing. Because when one person goes to the hospital and gets an MRI and doesn't have insurance, it costs $4,000. And if somebody goes and does have insurance, well, the price is only $1,500. And by the way, you only have to pay $150. You know, so we have a lot of disparity in pricing. And so I don't disagree with that. Help me out. Where am I wrong? What do I need to know?
No, I mean, you're absolutely right. We've talked about it on your show a number of times. Transparency is the key to a free market system operating appropriately. The consumer needs to have the information so they can make decisions. What the Trump administration is proposing here from a standpoint of prescription drugs, while on the surface it sounds good and well, the way that the prescription drug world works is through a process of what's called rebating. Now, rebates, which is what the Trump administration is proposing would go away, or think of them as a bonus or a commission that the drug manufacturer pays the wholesaler for selling a drug to the end pharmacy where you and I would get our drug. So it's all right. Happening behind the scenes. There's no transparency in it. So we could be encouraged to go get a drug at a lower price, but in the end, our insurance company's paying a higher price, but the PBM's getting a big bonus off of
now,
it.
Now, hold on. Let's make sure we don't do the jargon too far. Pharmacy benefit manager, that's a PBM. That's that middleman. Right. That's the person negotiating, right?
That's right.
All right, just so I'll be clear.
Okay. Yep. So you have the manufacturer who makes the drug, the PBM, or pharmacy benefit manager, who negotiates the price of the drug and then sells it to the pharmacy that you and I go get the drug from, right?
Correct.
And so the rebating structure has been historically a massive area of profit for these PBMs because they get bonus based on the amount of drugs they distribute from a manufacturer, right? And so years ago, though, the health insurance industry caught wind of this and said, hey, we're tired of paying these higher prices that you're encouraging based on the formulary structure. So we're out. Well, so what the PBM started doing was sharing the rebate with a health insurance company who, because of the Affordable Care Act, needed a new way to make money because they can only make so much spread on the premiums that
right,
they charge.
Right, so they got pinched a little bit, right.
Right. So this, I'm fine with these rebates going away, but let's call it what it is. This is a pebble in the ocean, and here's why. PBMs, pharmacy benefit managers, make their money on the spread. They buy the drug at one price, but then ultimately distribute it at a different price. This is called the AWP, or average wholesale pricing structure. And in addition, health insurance companies who used to be getting rebates from the PBMs now own the PBMs. Our Justice Department has allowed 70% of the drug distribution market to be now owned by the health insurance companies themselves.
Now, my concern is different here, and we're with Seth Denson. So, you know, a lot of things to sort through here, and you've got people on all sides of this conversation with a stake in it. But my concern goes to the manufacturers, the pharmacy companies themselves, and people say, why would you defend them? Here's why. Because these companies go out and spend billions of dollars on research and development, and oftentimes they go to a dry hole. Nothing comes of it. They don't make any money. Mm-hmm. And I want to make sure that the government doesn't overreach and put these companies in a place where they say, well, it's not worth the risk to go do this research and development. We're just going to skip it, because then we don't get new drugs that fight cancer, that fight heart disease, that deal with diabetes, because there's a tremendous amount of money involved to do the research, and they have to have a financial payoff to make it worth the while.
No, you're absolutely right and interesting. I've never been a big advocate of defending the drug manufacturing world either. However, if we look at the three parties involved in this, the manufacturer, the distributor, and the insurance company, the one that is actually the Boy Scout in all of this is the manufacturer. They put in the research and development. They put in the time, but they're not the ones that get the biggest amount of margin on this. It's the PBM and the insurance company. So this proposal by Alex Azar and Health and Human Services, it actually doesn't impact the manufacturer. And so that's a good thing because we want the manufacturer to keep developing drugs. What it does impact is the PBM and the insurance company who ultimately are charging you and me higher health insurance premiums, but getting the kickback on the back end.
Right. You know, and so I as long as we're clear on that, I'm good. But my concern always is when Kamala Harris and these others say, well, we're just going to get rid of the insurance companies. We're going to attack the insurance companies. We're going to attack Big Pharma. We're not going to have anything left. It's those folks that frighten me far more. I'll give you the last word.
Well, listen, the Kamala Harris and some of the other, we'll call them progressives, that are screaming for socialized medicine.
Oh, hell, just call them
that by looking at other countries who get to do socialized medicine because we don't. We develop here in the United States. If we didn't have a free market system and a capitalistic system, there wouldn't be advancement of medicine anymore. You're welcome, world. America's here to protect you.
You're welcome. Well, you know what, Kamala Harris, just call them what they are, communists. And then you're good with it. All right. I greatly appreciate it, Seth, as always.
Thanks, Steve. Good to be with you.
Have a great day.